buying a house is about location, then remodeling a house is about planning. This is the Homes and Construction Affairs Show. Remodeling a house is a big inconvenience, but a big payoff. If you're out there and considering on embarking on this extensively, worry no more. Today I have an expert, Charles Magara, and he's going to be guiding us on how we can have this process run smoothly. My name is Hilda Kamkama, your host.
Remodeling is basically reorganizing in construction what has been in existence and putting up or uplifting it to give it another beautiful look. The basics of how to remodel the house, like for example, one might be having the lights that are old aged because, you know, new looks, new designs of lights come, and then you want to change to reorganize the lighting in the house. Like for example, the way you're seeing here, we are using now basically the lights that are of a lower watts than the usual ones you used to have of 80 watts, but you can have enough light that you need in the house. Two, you might remodel the walls. You may find one has a living room that was occupied by about two or three people. Now the family has extended. He thinks he can reorganize, extend the walls, and, you know, arrange your living room to become that exclusivity. Then three, there is remodeling of the exterior. You might find the house was built in 1960s, 1970s. As we walk into this new era, new age, some new designs of houses, some new concepts, some new looks are coming out, and one would want to uplift his house and give it that exclusive, beautiful look. Well, we fall into interior designing. After remodeling the building or the house itself, then there is need now a rearrangement of the house. Like for example, the interior concepts, the living room, where do you need to place your seating, where do you need to have your living dining, where do you need now to have your bed, how does the bed fit in your bedroom, ceilings. We now remodel them into the gypsum kind of beautiful look. We do the gypsum ceilings. We do the painting because we need now to protect the walls. We need to treat the walls. And then we give them that exclusivity. The types of painting that are now on look. Like for example, we used it to have that old aged paint. But now today there are so many types of painting. There are new looks of paint that we have to redesign the painting, and then have the sitting room look beautiful and different, and you have the bedroom have maybe about two concepts or three colors, and then you have also your master suite arranged, and then give it that calm, welcoming lighting, and then the paint that gives you the ambience to be able to have the sleep. That is basically what we do as interior designers. This building was a mall. So whatever you're seeing here were rooms and apartments of shops. So there are lockups of shops here, and clients were renting these ones and then selling clothes, you know, selling all that stuff. But the owner of the building came to us and said he's not getting profits that he's expecting in his building. Then we came out with a concept that we could make this a beautiful hotel. So in designing the hotel, we looked at what makes a hotel. One is the ambience lounge. So this is one of the lounges that we have made for the clients. Whatever you're seeing here, we had to remove all the walls that were in between. We had to break off the glasses that were there, create the ones that are going to create the ambience and the air that we need. We had to create the columns differently, make them a beautiful look, the way you see them glossing and beautiful. Apply the exotic paint we are talking about, which is of our generation, the Italian stucco. And then we had to create our counter that is going to create the kitchen serving, like the way you could go to a number of hotels and cafes, and then you love the ambience. This is what we are creating now here. And the upper room, upper is going to be hotel rooms, but down here, this is the lounge now, where people sit, have their cup of coffee, have their dinner or their breakfast, and then they can be able to go back to the hotel or they can be able to move out. Basically, what we do as interior designers, we do not want the customer to spend more, but we want that very space that you have to be able to create something that is a little bit unique and beautiful by using what is in existence, then remodeling it into becoming a beautiful look. Like for example, this was a beamed ceiling that was plain and open. So we came out with three things that we need to put here. One was the flooring, give an exotic, beautiful tiling that is going to rhyme with our color scheming, the way you are seeing that the tiles and the walls and how we have separated them blend well. Floor had a uniform tile that was rough texture for the conveniency and the traffic of customers who were coming to the shops. So now this is now a hotel where we had to create another look of the tiles. Then in the ceiling, it was a beam full and nothing was there. So we came out with the concept of the gypsum ceilings and the molded cornices. Then we can be able to arrange the lighting accordingly. Well, these are powdered boards imported from wherever out of the country. They are here. Whoever wants them, you can source them, they are around. But remodeling and designing is where the interior design come from. So what we do, we mend these boards, we fix them in between the ceiling to create that executive spacing for the lighting and the strip lighting. We also model the cornices to give it an uplift lighting. So there is what is called hidden light that you are not seeing in here, but it is in here. Okay. It takes lower watts. We also create these lights because if you look at these wires here, they had our big lights for the lockups. So every lockup had a light here. So we are trying to phase out that edge. We are getting lighter and good, beautiful lights with lower watts of about 3 watts. So if you look at these lights that were here, we are consuming more electricity than the many spotlights you're seeing here, which are consuming less light, but they're giving you the beauty. After the ceiling, then we go back to the columns. Many people think that the more beams, the house will look ugly. No, we come out with a beautiful look of the beam. It can stand alone, but give it an executive look, create the color scheme for it, polish it and give it that exquisite Italian stucco, and one would look at it and admire it. That is basically what we are doing here. As the interior designers, we came out with a design, shared it with our client, with his color scheme that is going to rhyme with. For example, I'm not the one who's going to buy the chairs.
Okay.
I'm not the one who's going to buy in the cutlery and all that stuff. But according to the client and where he's sourcing these things, the chairs, the cushions and all that stuff, I rhyme with his colors to bring out the ambience. We have a kind of product which is a paint. We design it, remodel, polish it, and it looks like plastic.
What is that kind of paint?
The paint is called Italian stucco. You can only source it from our company, Maz Coatings. Mm. Then you give us a visit, look at the different types of those paints, the different colors, and then we can be able to create it for you. It doesn't go only on columns, it can go on the future walls, it can go on the corridors, for as long as it is going to give you that exquisitive look that separates you from the other clients. They see these things on Facebook, in other countries, and they admire them. They actually don't know that there are companies, there are people who can be able to do these things. And this is exactly what we are doing here. This is what we offer to our clients. Visit us, check the product, and let us give you that exclusive look, that exclusive ambience of your house that is a little bit different from the others. And that's where the world is going. You understand? It's not that these things, we admire them from afar. They are now here in Uganda. You can have your gypsum beautiful design ceiling. Mm-hmm. You can have your wall created and designed very well, that when someone visits your house, the most important thing is our viewers, our customers do not want to specialize and invite that technical person to be able to give you this. So they are known to painters that everyone can be able to paint. Yes, it is true, but who gives you that color scheming, the blending, the designing, and the extra look of that house? It takes a profession. These are boards, but we have machinery that designs these boards into any design, anything that I want, and then I can be able to shape it out. What we're doing here, we are creating a cafe. So this, the coffee machines, the food, and the kitchen is behind. It will be served here, and then here, the customer can come here and get his food from here. So what we're creating here is basically the ambience of the counter, where you're accessing your coffee from here, and then you can be able to take it away, or you can be able to eat from here, where this area is going to have your beautiful chairs, then you sit, and then you can be served your beautiful meal, and then you can be able to move out. If it's a new building, and one is thinking of putting up a beautiful hotel, we come in at a stage where plastering has been done. You have not yet tiled, you have done your plumbing, but you have not yet done your full wiring. Because sometimes we find wiring is done differently and we want to arrange the lighting differently, so we have to redo the wiring. So we come in at a time when you have just done the plastering. We come now to advise you. Interior designers, we are working with all stakeholders. We work with engineers, we work with the electrical team, we work with the plumbing team. Just for example, if you look at this beautiful counter washing table, it wasn't here. So this actually was a lockup for someone. And now I'm turning it to be an area of food. I don't think that I will ask my customer to first go to the washroom and then come back to eat. So I must create for him a washing table. So what I have done is to work with a plumber to extend for me water system here, and then I can be able to create the counter. So I work with all stakeholders to come out with a beautiful organization of the area. And that's where you need now an interior designer. Mm-hmm. You basically hiring this person or this company to be able to handle for you that by detailing every piece of what you need in a cafe or a restaurant. So I'm not going to think about the food served here when I'm not thinking how you're going to walk in here. So I'll have to give you security to be able to come through. I'll have to create for you the beautiful chair which is going to welcome you. I'm going to create where you're going to be able to wash your hands and be able to find your food beautifully. Where should you be served food? It's not coming directly from the kitchen. You need to find it somewhere smart and be able to access it when it is convenient and safe for you. No small project either. Everyone who has stepped out and put up a house, you need to give him a credit. Mm-hmm. It's not easy to build a house. It is not easy. There is a lot of expenditure that you have to go through, but also to get something beautiful, you have to go through stress. And sometimes that's why you see people fail even to finish their houses. True. Because from the first stage to the second stage, he has exhausted all his money because he has people who have not guided them. And they have done things that are not well organized. So what we do, you invite us. Basically, what happens is our customers think, oh, wow, they're expensive. They are expensive. We are basically service providers that help you to put up something beautiful. And all you do is to invite these professionals. Take them to your project, give them your idea. This is my house, this is my sitting room, this is how I thought about it, this is the corridor, this is where we go to the bedroom one, the bedroom two, this is what I desire to have. Through your own concept mind, now I help you to put this into place, to put them together, then I remind you that you have forgotten that the door to your bathroom should be opening like this. Your living room's ceiling needs to be uplifted. Your door is a little bit squeezed, so there is congestion of traffic if your visitors were to enter. And then we agree whether we can adjust the door or we adjust the spacing. We agree to adjust the window or not adjust the window. And then when we don't, what should we use as an alternative? And when it comes to the cost, you discuss with your client. Tells you, you know what, I cannot afford this. Give me an alternative. As a profession person, I can tell you, Ugandans think everything's about money. Everything is about money. It's not. You call me and I visit your house. We have services. We drive there. We visit your house. We give you ideas. Through these ideas, you choose to use Mars coatings or not to use Mars coatings. There is no cost there. You get it? At a time when you allow Mars coatings to take on as your interior designer to finish your house both inside and outside, then there is going to be a quotation. So this quotation is where we involve each other on what we have discussed, what is to be done, and how much I am offering. Yes. The client says, no, it is too costly, I will not manage. Then I ask, how much would you manage? And then I give you an alternative. We have done so many houses and they are not expensive. They are not expensive, but they are exquisite. Like I told you, that when you go to buy a silk vinyl, your painter goes to buy paint inside, silk vinyl, the normal color cream or soft white. If you invited your interior designer, would look at the beautiful doors you have created, looks at the ceiling, and asks you to consider this kind of color to match your chairs and your dining. I mean, it's the same price. The color does not determine the paint. It's the same price, but now you're having a unique look just because you've changed the color, which is color scheming. We do go back to creating color that will blend with what you have in existence. And that is not costly because the paint remains the same. But also, our customers have not been well equipped with information. When you ask the painter, he's going to use the normal products that are on the market. But actually, these companies have so many products that you would want to use, and they are there and almost equal to the same price that you are using. Like, for example, I'll give you an example. If I wanted to paint my future wall, and the painter tells you you should use silk, the price of silk, their products, there is a mosaic text like the one you're seeing here, there is Italian stucco, there are paints like Godego Creco. These products are there in the market, but they're the same price. This is called mosaic text. It has two unique advantages. Mosaic is made of materials like quartz. They come from India. It's a stone kind of finish, but it is made, processed, and it can be able to sit on any other wall and create that ambience of beauty, but at the same time, it's also protecting your walls. It can be used both inside and outside. You only change the design of the product. Yes, if it is for outside, then it has to be created differently, has to have a different texture, but also it has to be a little bit stronger than the one that is inside. But the one that is inside, you can create it in different colors. Like for example, like I said, our color scheme here is our chocolate brown and our moonbeam kind of finish. So we had to create that in that color. But you can have it in white, you can have it in a mix of white, red and green, white, red and blue, according to your house, according to your curtaining, and then it can be able to bring out the future wall that you need. So once he tells you so, you take them through the process. By changing this, this is what is going to happen. By changing this, this is what you're going to have. By changing this, there's going to be this cost. And then someone thinks about the three and says, you know what, let's go with this. And then you help them to understand what they want. Not everyone understands what he wants. He has seen it on Facebook, has seen it on Google, has seen on someone's house, and then that's what he wants. But according to his house, it might not be able to be applied. So you help this customer to take him through and then give them an alternative, and then you get through. It's a process. It's not something that you can do once. No. These are two different things. One, we are looking at where do we put our bottles. Like, for example, someone wants a glass of wine, and someone wants some cocktail and all that stuff. The products have to be placed in here. But also, they shouldn't be hung or kept somewhere where they are not safe and where they are not looking beautiful. So we create the wall wardrobes for this kitchen. The wall wardrobes which have, which can keep bottles, they can keep wines, they can keep some syrups for the chef here to be able to access them easily. But also, it also helps the customer who's seated behind there to be able to look at it and say, oh wow, I do not want the white sweet wine. I want the dry, yes, or the red sweet wine. But he's seeing it there and he's making a choice and an alternative. That's why we created this. It's going to have lights to garnish the bottles to be able to give it some hype. Create a marble, because whatever is going to happen here, you expect oil, you expect water and all that stuff. So you need to create a marble top that is heat resistant, but also it is acidic resistant. That's why we create these marbles on the tops. It helps someone to be able to clean it off. It helps someone to be able to avoid acid to eat up the walls and to eat up the cabinets and all that stuff. So we use the marble, which is a little bit expensive, but it helps you out to have something durable. Days have gone where we used to have the carpentry kitchen cabinets done, installed with plaster and cement and bricks, and it will never move, it will never do any other thing. It is just stuck for years and years. Now we are modernizing everything, that this kitchen, the one you're seeing today, if this client wanted to shift and change it to look differently, it is very easy. These worktops are movable. These cabinets are movable. They are not stuck on the wall. So you can be able to pull it off, push it on the other side, pull this one, put it on this other side. And that helps you to have another new look of your kitchen. You might be here and you think, you know what? This is my home kitchen. Yeah. I think I'm tired of entering from here because the children are dirtying the walls and all that stuff. Let me push it and face it the other side. And you can be able to do that. And then it's given spacing. But even if you wanted to work out a worktop that your children, you want them to sit and then come and eat with you, you have visitors in the dining, you want to have a conversation with them when you're cooking for them, you create tables and some chairs in here so they can be able to be pulled out, and then you can sit here, your friend can visit you, sit here as you cook for him or her if it is your home. And then we can be able to only extend this. You don't have to do much. You only extend the marble a little bit upper, then create your stools, and then your visitor who is in the sitting room can come join you in the kitchen, because some loving kitchen, pull the seat, sit with you as you do the cooking. And this is what we are doing, modernizing the house, giving it a better look than how it was before. Two have two advantages. One, marble for traffic and acid. That's cool. But Uganda is blessed in one way or the other. Why? We have the best wood in the whole world. Uganda is blessed, has the best wood in the whole world. Talk of Mugavu, talk of Mahogany, talk of Musambia. Whatever you can use here is equally as marble.
Okay.
If you did it well, treat it well, varnish it well, you can have it as your worktop. And it will remain the way it is. All you have to do is clean it every day, and it will remain for more than 50 years. All you do is service it. Well, this is mahogany wood, and it's given a thicker, it's a little bit thicker to be able to be like a marble, and then it can be able to hold whatever heavy thing is put on top of it.